Hi guys, MJ here, and welcome to the next movie on the channel. I'm on my way to meet Adam and Kuba for a coffee and a small photo walk. And by the way, I have something that might interest you, which is brand new Lomocolor 92. And today we are going to test it out in a pretty interesting camera. But starting with camera.
Today I want to present you a really great entry-level camera, which is Konica Autoreflex T. It's fully mechanical, classic SLR with shutter priority auto exposure and a built-in light meter. I got it with an absolute amazing Hexanon 57mm f1.4, which is a really great and bright everyday use lens. Shutter speed up to 1000th of a second, bulb mode, shutter lock, and a couple square shutter. It's a really solid gear. You can buy it for less than $100, even with this amazing lens. And it's good working condition. The only one counts for me is weight. Body and lens is over 1 kilo.
All right, if you know everything about the gear, let's go.
It's good to know that you have 100% working camera from the greatest service in the world. Yeah, good to know, right?
Yeah, it's good to know. Yeah, I know this guy, MJ Kowski. Yeah, that's right.
First impressions about the film stack, it's really, really grainy. And it generates a lot of green tint in the shadows.
Weather conditions are really mixed today. Anyway, we'll test this rollout in the mixed conditions.
But I heard from Adam, who already tested out this roll, that not in a full sun or not in a golden hour, it doesn't look that well as in a full sun or a golden hour conditions. But we will test it out in the shadows anyway, because I really like to shoot in the shadow, so I want to roll to look very good in the shadows, like XP2.
We are in the middle of the street and two good looking guys in the reflection. Can this day be better?
Thank you.
I'm trying to test it out in a mixed weather conditions and in the mixed, what's going on behind me, in the mixed weather conditions and in the mixed color conditions. I'm looking for some warm colors, cold colors, shadows and a full sun. And I'm really curious about the results. Let's go. And here we are on a winding competition. It was less than 6 seconds.
Let's go.
Dr. Pepper, the only soda to manage to do something with their lives and get a doctorate.
Okay, so here we are with the mixed conditions for today. We got a cloudy sky right now, and I think it's the best moment to check some portraits of guys and check how the skin tones are presented on a Lomo 92. Let's go. I like the final results, but it's really hard to handle the shadow situation, to take care of a green tint that it's visible on almost every shot. I really don't know what conditions are the best for this film stock, but it's definitely not an easy one to handle.
Yeah, it looks pretty interesting, especially this hole inside this thing right there.
So you understand the shape, how does he know how to put it?
To put it where?
Then it started to rain, so we tried to hide, and as you probably already know, the best place to hide is your favorite coffee shop, where I realized that Lomo 92 is a really great tungsten lightning film stock. It handled the tungsten light really well. Final thoughts about the Lomo 92. It's a difficult film stock and it can produce a really interesting 90s look. One roll is not a lot to test it out for sure. I really want to shoot more of this film stock, especially during golden hours.
And here we are, back to where it all started, and without any extended endings. Thank you very much for watching. Let's do all the crazy stuff around the channel if you want to and if you enjoy the video, and see you in the next one. Take care, guys.